So good morning all the 7th standard students. We are going to study the lesson The Bull. And till now what we have seen in the story? Children, till now we have seen in the story that our two brothers are there and they are stepbrother. Okay? And they don't have good understanding among them. Okay? And one brother is farmer. So let me write one name is O-N. So one brother is a farmer. One brother is farmer. Another brother is painter. Last class, what we saw in the story? That the brother who is farmer, he is becoming a little bit angry, okay? He is becoming a little bit angry. Why he is becoming a little bit angry? Because, example, he is able to sell the cow in 100 rupees. So his brother who is painter, he is able to sell the painting of the cow. So this type of thing used to happen. So you go to the page number 68, okay, and we can start from the beginning of page number 68. You see, backward and niggardly, which is congratulation, he would have to see and acknowledge the main excellence of that redoubtable animal. What is the meaning of redoubtable animal? Means the animal which deserves respect. Some weeks ago, while on a business journey to Taunton, Tom had been invited by his half brother to visit a studio in that town. So now you can see that Tom is invited by the brother. Tom, while he was going to which place? He was going to the place Taunton. T-A-U-N-T-O-N, Taunton. Okay, so that time, while having the visit to the brother studio, where Lawrence was exhibiting one of his picture, a large canvas representing a bull standing knee deep in some marshy ground. It had been good of its kind, no doubt, and Lawrence had seemed inordinately pleased with it. So Lawrence is happy to see that his brother is going to auction one picture, and the picture is of the cow, which I said, okay. And you can see, the best thing I have done it, he has said, and over again, and Tom had generously agreed that it was fairly like. Means, he was continuously speaking that, I have done so many painting, but this is my best painting. This is my best painting. The best painting I have done. Right? Now the man of pigment was going to be shown a real picture, a living model of strength and comeliness, a thing to feast the eyes on that exhibition, new pose and action with every shifting minute instead of standing glued into one unvarying attitude between the four walls of the frame. So now he started just giving all his focus everywhere, means what the picture are, not means in the four wall of the frame, okay. Tom unfastened a short wooden door and led the way into a straw bedded yard. And now Tom is going to the straw bedded yard. Is it quiet? Asked the artist. As a young bull with a curly red coat court came inquiringly towards them. So that time what happened? One young bull is also coming towards them. Now see children, what is understanding, what is interesting here, which we have to understand? One brother is there. That brother used to make the painting of cow. One more brother is there. That brother used to raise the cow. Means he used to have the cow, real cow, in the agriculture field, in the cattle. Both are stepbrother. Both are not having good understanding. Okay, both are jealous of each other. In this story, as we are able to read. Now, the difference is coming in their thought also. The brother who is farmer, who is thinking that how the people will pay this much, a huge money for a non-living thing. If they will buy the real cow, they can get the milk also. What they will get in this painting? And the one who is painter, no, he is saying, this is my best art. Till now, whatever I have made, this is my best art. So, the difference in opinion is there. And this difference in opinion is because of different profession, children. Okay. This difference in opinion is because of difference in profession. He is playful at times, said Tom. So, Tom is saying that this bull which is coming now is playful at times, leaving his half-brother to wonder whether the bull's ideas of play were of the catch as catch can order. Lawrence made one or two perfunctory comments on the animal's appearance and asked a question or so as to his age and such like details. Then he coolly turned the talk into another channel. So his brother is changing the topic to another topic so that he should not feel offended like this. Any child want to read this paragraph? Do you remember the picture I showed you at Taunton? He asked. 7th standard children, anyone want to read this? So Ankita, Kanchan, Ahana, Akriti, Sambhav, any child want to read? You think you can improve your skill of reading, children? If you are listening in the class, you say yes or no. Say yes, sir. If you are listening, say yes, sir. Okay, so you read. Who said yes or no? You read this paragraph. Do you remember the picture I showed you at Taunton?
The page number?
Page number 68. Last paragraph. Do you remember the picture?
Do you remember the picture I showed you at Taunton? He asked. Yes, grunted Tom. A white-faced bull standing in some slush. Don't admire those Herefords much myself. Bulky-looking bruts don't seem to have much life in them. They are easier to paint that way. Now, this younger beggar is on the move all the time, aren't you, fairy?
Okay, stop. So now what is happening? Both the brothers, they started talking, okay? So first, the brother is asking question that, do you remember the picture which I showed you at Taunton? He asked. He is giving reply, yes, I remember. And in the picture, what was there? A white-faced bull standing in some slush. Slush means you can say a ground where the grasses are there, okay, where the watery mud is there. Don't admire those hair fold. Okay, see the meaning. Animals of a breed of red and white, beef, cattle. So you can say that the breed animal, okay, of two different breed. Much myself, how bulky looking brutes don't seem to have much life in them, and how these cattle are looking. The cattle are looking like they are not having much life in them. Dare say they are easier to paint that way. Now this young beggar is on the move all the time. Aren't you fairy? And asking that this beggar is always moving, okay? Are you not a fairy? Asking the question to the bull itself. Okay, you can see the picture also, children, how the sheep are looking. You see, very innocent the sheep are looking. Okay, now page number 69. Yes, page number 69. Anyone read?
Yes. I have sold that picture, said Lawrence with considerable complacency in his voice. Have you? Said Tom. Glad to hear it, I am sure. Hope you are pleased with what you have got for it.
Okay,
so I got 300 pounds for it, said Lawrence.
Okay, so after one paragraph you wait also. So now you see, both the brothers are talking and Lawrence is saying that you have seen that picture. No, that picture now I have sold. Okay, I got the money for that picture. So his brother is saying that I hope you are happy with the money what you got. Okay, so he is saying yes, I got 300 pounds for it. Okay, now you read again. From Tom turned towards him with a slowly rising flush of anger in his face. So now the brother, he became angry. Okay, now the facial expression of the brother is changing. That real cow I am selling in 100 pounds and the painting you are selling in 300 pounds. What is this? Unfair. Okay, so you read this.
Tom turned towards him with a slowly rising flush of anger in his face. 300 pounds under the most favorable market condition that he could imagine, his wrist cover fairy would hardly fetch 100. Yet here was a piece of varnished canvas painted by his half brother, selling for three times that sum. It was a cruel insult that went home with all the more force because it impressed him triumph of the patronizing, self-satisfied Lawrence.
Okay, so what happened? Now he started thinking that if I will sell the cow in now favorable market and condition, 100 pounds only I will get, and how the brother is able to do this. And then he started thinking it was a cruel insult that went home with all the more faces because it emphasized the term of the patronizing, self-satisfied Lawrence. So Lawrence, the painter, he is self-satisfied. But his brother, he became very much upset, angry that how this is happening, real cow, 100 rupees, and you see this painting he is doing 300 rupees. Okay. The young farmer had meant to put his relative just a little out of conceit with himself by displaying the jewel of his possessions. So he wanted to keep his relatives away from his affairs, right? Because of the possessiveness. Possessiveness means the one who is claiming ownership. Like I am saying, this is my house, this is my responsibility, this I have to do, that I have to do. So these things are said to be the possessors. And now the tables were turned and his valued beast was made to look cheap and insignificant beside the price meant for a bare picture. Now when he started looking at the cow, so he started thinking that my cows are cheap and the pictures are very costly. It was so monstrously unjust and he thought this is unjust. Okay. The painting would never be anything more than a fresh piece of fodder field life. And then he started saying that painting is what? Painting is only a dextrous. You see the meaning in the book, showing or having skill. Counterfeit copied. So painting is a painting is copy of life. Okay, see, one common thing from here we can learn, the students, that if you do any profession, no, you think that profession is the hard and best one, right? And you used to think other profession that it is very easy. Have you seen anyone who used to say that teaching is very easy, only you have to take the book in hand and you have to read the lesson and then you have to say to the children, stand up and sit down? Have you seen this type of people, children? Say yes sir or no sir.
No sir.
No. It is good.
No sir.
Not seen, okay. So teaching is not easy and it is not difficult also. So I encourage all the children, in future anyone can become teacher. This is very good job. Okay. So you should like the children, first of all. Second, you should have good knowledge of the subject. Third, you should have patience. Fourth, you should have communication skill. Fifth, you should be always ready to help the children in their studies. And sixth, you are teaching them so that the society can be better. Okay. If you like teaching, then teaching is the best profession in the world. Okay. While Clover Fairy was the real thing, a monarch in his little world, a personality in the countryside, after he was dead, even he would still be something of a personality. So even if the animal is dead also, the animal is a personality. His descendant would gaze in those valley meadows and hillside pastures. And even the animal is dead, the offspring of the animal, they will go to the meadows and they will be just proud of their forefather. They would fill stall and bear and milking shed. Their good red coats would speckle the landscape and crowd the marketplace. Men would note a promising heifer for or a well proportioned steer and say, "Our dad one comes of good old Clover Fairy's stock." All that time the picture would be hanging, lifeless and unchanging, beneath its dust and varnish. A chatter that ceased to mean anything if you choose to turn it with its back to the wall. These thoughts chased themselves angrily through Tom Yorkfield's mind, but he could not put them into words. When he gave tongue to his feeling, he puts matters bluntly and harshly. This line is very important, which I want to share to all of you. He is having a lot of feelings and emotions, but all the feelings and emotions he is not able to express, because whenever he is giving the tongue to his feelings and emotions, he used to speak very bluntly and harshly. Means a person who is good from inside, but he is having language issue, okay? No one likes him or her because of the, I'm just checking the time, language issue, okay? Some soft-witted fools, you see the meaning of soft-witted fools, lacking sense or judgment. Means those who are not having good sense of understanding or judgment. Fools may like to throw away 300 pounds on a bit of paintwork. And then this person is saying that, oh, I guess why the people are able to give 300 pounds? Because I think they are foolish people. Because for painting only, they are giving 300 pounds. What is this? In 100 pounds, they can get a real cup. So like this, he started thinking, okay? And then you see, he nodded towards the young bull that was alternately staring at them with nose held high and lowering its horn with a half playful, half impatient shake of the head. And when they both were discussing these things. That time one bull is there whose head is downside, horn is high, and he is looking half playful. Playful means in the mood to play, means to attack someone maybe little bit, and looking impatient. Impatient means eager to do something, okay? Like that he is going to do. So page number 70, you all see, Lawrence laughed a laugh of irritating indulgent amusement. So that time Lawrence started laughing, okay? And because of this laugh, he thought that, oh, fools are there in this world. That's why they are able to buy the painting. And he is able to run his business. So children, two things are there. My stepbrother is able to do business. Why? Because he is a good painter? No. Because fools are there in the world. And these fools can buy this painting. Okay, this is the thought. You see, this thought I think is not good. Personally, I feel. So very soon you all join the children. Okay. One more class today we have.